Hello guys, in today's quick tutorial, I will show you how to update your Debian Linux or Kali Linux in this tutorial. So let's open up command terminal. First thing, I'm going to explain the difference between apt and apt-get, which most people use to update their system, their Linux system. So in any Linux or even FreeBSD, if you don't know how to use command, you can run the main command for manual, and we can run the main command for apps. So apps provides a high level command line interface for the package management system, while apt-get is a more specialized apt tools. Apt, don't get confused between app and apt. Apt stand for advanced packaging tool. So the command app update, it used to update the information from all config sources. And app upgrade, it used to install all the available upgrades of all the packages that are currently on the system via the sources.list. Full upgrade perform a function of upgrade, but it will remove the currently installed packages if this is needed to upgrade the system as a whole. So you caution when you use the command for that upgrade, there's certain packages can be removed from your system automatically. And install, reinstall, remove, or purge, it's for you to manually install the package, remove the package. The only difference between remove and purge, remove will remove the package, but purge also remove the configuration for that packages from the system. Auto remove. So when you update the packages, there are certain the older dependency that no longer needed it for that applications, and over time it's gonna build up in your storage. So auto remove gonna remove all the packages that no longer needed at dependencies for the packages. And list is basically list all the packages on your system. And let's look for the apt-get real quick. So apt-get is actually a lot more offering a lot more command than the app. However, Debian and a lot of Linux distro actually recommended average users to use the app command instead of the apt-get. All right, so let's get started. We'll get the Kali Linux update. So the first command you're gonna run it sudo app update. And it downloading the update from the sources dot list. All right, when that completed, if you want to see the upgradable list, you can run the command app list dot dash upgradable. And we'll list this other packages that upgradable. You can manually upgrade them, or you can use the command sudo app upgrade to upgrade all of them. And Y for yes. Sometimes if it fail, you can rerun the command again, and it's gonna go past this. All right, now that we have all the packages upgraded, the last step is to run the apps auto remove commands, so it can remove some of the no longer needed dependency. So that's why it's gonna save us a little bit of storage. So we're gonna go run a sudo app auto remove command. And as you see, we 946 megabyte will be free for the storage. It's not much for storage nowadays, but over time, all the unused dependency it can actually start building up. So it's a good idea to run the auto remove command every time you run the app update and app upgrade command. And that concludes today's tutorial. If you think it's helpful, don't forget to subscribe, like, and thank you for all your, the support for my channel. And I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Bye-bye.